right, so I just want to make two things clear because I think that they might be confusing about confidence intervals. And that's there's two kinds of confidence intervals. I mean, it's just one confidence interval, but we use it in two different situations. One is when we have proportions, and one is when we have averages. So proportions, the basic equation for a confidence interval always is going to be that your confidence interval is going to be for proportions, your p hat, right? That's your point estimate. Plus or minus the margin of error. So I feel like you guys know this pretty well. The one thing to be clear is how to find the margin of error. So for this, we've got to figure out how do we find the margin of error. And the margin of error is always your z-score times your standard error. So we're still just using all these letters. So I need to figure out how do I find the standard error. With proportions, our standard error is always going to be the best estimate we have for standard deviation, which is p hat times 1 minus p hat over n. So I can just replace this right here with that statement. So this is how we basically find proportions. The entire equation, one long part of it, it would be p hat plus or minus z times the square root of p hat times 1 minus p hat over n. We're pretty good at this. The thing that we haven't spent enough time on is averages. We can find confidence intervals for averages too. It's the exact same equation or the same general equation, except that our point estimate is going to be x bar, not p hat, plus or minus the margin of error. Margin of error, again, is just going to be z times your standard error. The big difference here is that our standard error is not this equation. Okay? The standard error, when you're dealing with averages, is always, sigma over the square root of n, where sigma is that standard deviation. So for this equation, I would replace the standard error with sigma over square root of n. And if I write the entire equation for confidence interval when I'm dealing with means, it would be my x bar plus or minus z times sigma over the square root of n. So I just want you to be sure to realize if I'm doing an average problem, I use these equations, and when I'm doing proportions, I use these.